Un altro punto su cui i critici della MMT insistono è quello del tasso di cambio flessibile. Una flessibilità del cambio offre sicuramente un maggior margine di intervento nell'economia volto al sostegno della domanda e dell'occupazione. Ma un tasso di cambio fluttuante è sempre auspicabile? Pensiamo ad esempio a quei paesi in via di sviluppo che hanno una necessità quasi vitale di detenere valuta estera con la quale pagare le importazioni e o rimborsare il debito estero. La MMT come si pone dinanzi a questi casi specifici?
Another MMT point often criticized is the flexible exchange rate. For sure, a flexible exchange rate provides a wide margin of intervention in the economy by supporting the aggregate demand and employment. The question, is a flexible exchange rate system always desirable? Let's consider developing countries that need to accumulate reserves in foreign currency in order to pay for import and/or pay for foreign debt denominated in foreign currency. What is the position of MMT in these cases?
Yeah, well, let's just state what MMT claims, which is that all things equal, floating your currency gives you more domestic policy space. Because if you try to peg your currency, then you need foreign currency in order to meet your promise to exchange at a pegged rate against the foreign currency. You could also peg the gold, but that's history. That's not what people are doing now. They're pegging to a foreign currency. So that reduces your domestic policy space, and you actually need foreign currency to make your promise to convert on demand plausible, believable. I would restate the question to say that it's the countries that have pegged their exchange rates that must have foreign currency. The countries that float their currency actually don't have to have foreign currency. Okay? So I would reverse the implications of the question. Now, if you're a developing country and you've floated your currency, do you need foreign exchange? It is possible that you do need foreign exchange if you need to import goods or services, and the sellers will only accept foreign currency, okay? And that is a constraint, and we completely agree that a developing country that must import, let's say, machinery, that they can't produce any machinery on their own, they need some foreign currency in order to import it, because nobody will accept their currency. That situation could exist, okay? The question is whether pegging to the foreign currency will give them more access to it. And I find that implausible. What it does is it opens up the possibility of an exchange rate crisis. If you have made a promise to convert and people start looking at your foreign currency reserves and they say, well, we don't believe you have enough, there's going to be a run against your currency. If you have floated the currency and you're earning foreign currency in order to import, your imports are constrained by your ability to export something or to get direct investment or to rely on international charity. And it seems to me that you still have more policy space by floating your currency, even though you are severely constrained in what you can import. Pegging to a foreign currency doesn't expand your options. In fact, it exposes you to currency crises. So I would say, even in the case of a developed country, developing country, it's still better to float. Now, does that mean I would say there is never any situation in which pegging your exchange rate is a good idea? No, I wouldn't go that far. Okay, let's take a look at China. Can China defend the exchange rate that it wants? Now, China isn't pegging at an absolutely fixed rate. They adjusted and they've increased the value of the RMB over the years significantly, and just recently they decided to reduce the value slightly, but they are certainly managing their exchange rate system. Is it to their advantage? Probably it has been to their advantage to do that, at least up to the present day. Will they eventually float? Yes, eventually they will float, and eventually they're going to need to float. The reason is because they are very likely to start running current account deficits. But as long as they could run very large current account surpluses, was it to their advantage to manage their exchange rate, to keep it low, and to also manage their capital account? It probably was. So I'm not someone who's going to argue that always, in every single case, you should always float your exchange rate, you should never manage your exchange rate. No, I'm not. I'm just saying that floating your exchange rate in most circumstances is going to give you more domestic policy space. But that might not be your main objective at a particular point in history. And in China's case, it was more important to export and to develop productive capacity for some decades, and managing the exchange rate made sense for them.